stuff, Vic was playing. Okay, it was a joke.
It's not about that. It's everything.
Like I told you before, Vic is my...
What are you trying to say?
I'm not trying... And his friend Vic are to figure out how we all together can fix this...
Make some adjustments in his personal life off the court. But that's a learning process. Almost sounds like a threat. And Dom Pagnotti doesn't take too kindly to threats. Is this a threat?
Call it what you will.
We all know that Vic is a problem. The only person who doesn't seem to realize that is my brother. Sorry, bro, but enough is enough.
I don't have a problem with what you're saying. I have a problem with how you're saying it. Now, I know we can come to some understanding without all the ultimatums or threats.
Can we all come to a understanding, a compromise?
No. No more compromises. I already warned Freak. I told you. Don't be a hero. Cut that zero. It's cut Vic loose, or we trade Freak. It's that simple.
Fine. We'll go sign with another team.
Good luck with that, Pagnotti. Because of Vic... Freak's reputation precedes him.
No. What's good, you two?
Also, Freak's God-given talent, his reputation precedes him.
Everybody's been talking. Dom, you know how this works. This is not about you and me and our history. This is about your client. Help him.
You're talking as if I'm invisible. You're talking around me, about me, but not to me. Vic has always had my back. And I've given this team everything I got. I practice hard. I play hard. Yeah, some nights I got it, some nights I don't. Some days I might even show up a little late to shoot arounds. But every time I'm on that court, I've always given my best. And I see how it is, though. I mean, us players gotta be loyal to you, but you don't have to be loyal to us players. Try to give me some father and son talk, talking about how you love your players and how you look up for them. Come on, man. You trying to cut me off like you cut off Izzy. Don't you have people loyal to you no matter what? People you can't cut off? Well, that's me and Vic. Vic and me. Y'all insist, really. They could tell me stop hanging with Vic. What makes you think they won't tell me stop talking to you? You remember in seventh grade, some guys were trying to jump me over some girl. Vic was the one to get some friends just to walk me home. And when they came, we went at it, but I wasn't alone. When I got my scholarship, it was Vic who put the word on the streets that nobody should mess with me because I had a future. Vic was protecting me. And sir, I know Vic is crazy. But before all the hype and the lights, media, fans, it was just me and Vic. He's always been there. I mean, if y'all don't like that, I don't know what to say.
It hurts me to say this, but I see his point. What you don't understand is that the league doesn't have your back anymore. Not like they used to. They try, but it's too much. Social media has changed everything. And this last incident with Vic, that was the final straw.
It was a joke.
It wasn't funny. You know it wasn't a joke. Vic was defending you, stepping in to protect your honor by attacking another teammate like that? Talking about his manhood, his wife, his kids, his...
Media. He's
our squad who don't want to be here because of that beef. There is no place for that kind of inappropriate behavior in this league. If you can't trust your teammates, who can you trust?
What Vic is doing isn't right. He's bringing you down, and people can see it. I see how all the other players are looking at you.
What, don't talk to him?
Pudgy!
Don't hang with him?
You do what you gotta do, that's your call.
What the freak show to Mike?
You asked me if I had friends that I couldn't cut
off. What's good?
Yeah, I did for a while. There's girlfriends, wives, family that I thought I couldn't cut off.
Crunchy!
I learned that sometimes you gotta make the hard decisions. I mean, some of the
people... What's up with your mic?
They were bringing me down.
What the fuck?
They were good for the time that they were there, but I grew up. Not in age or maturity.
Yo,
mind,
yo.
Spirit. I was
ready
for the next level of my life. And I'll be honest with you,
I've been
on the receiving end of that. Oh, cut off myself.
Wait,
yeah, it
hold
hurt
on.
At the time,
wait,
but looking back,
Crunchy, I'm gonna get my DJ at Wednesday.
Just don't tell my ass like that, Pagnotti.
So what's the next
Wednesday?
Yeah, Wednesday.
Question is, are you ready and willing to do what needs to be done?
Nigga! Cause you got 2K, bro? Cause you got 2K, bro?
Huh?
You got 2K?
Yeah.
Wanna play it?
I gotta tell you something, bro.
What's up?
You take a moment to think about it, but think long.
Don't tell Marty or Marty.
What happened?
You got games to
freaks. Gotta handle your business.
Okay. Boss it up.
What happened?
Omari was talking.
I gotta tell Neji. Cause Neji gonna go off. You know Neji, but Neji go off.
No.
Yeah, you already know. You already go off. You already know. Yo.
Dom.
I had him call you.
Why?
I'm gonna cut right to the chase. My brother is deeply in love with you. And I'm ready to put our differences aside if you are.
Really?
On a string.
I'm with it.
Team Freak.
Team Freak.
All right, so if you're gonna be down with the team, I gotta show you the dap.
Oh, the dap?
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay, look at this.
Oh.
One, two, three,
shoot,
swish.
Swish.
Yeah. Again, play.
Mm-hmm. Oh, okay. One, two, three, swish.
Yeah.
Okay, like that.
Cool, right?
Yeah.
Boys and ladies, it's about to get lit up in here. I would start the game up. It's the last game too.
This is it. The last game of my rookie season. Kind of hard to believe. These 82 games have gone by in a blur. I know we're on the outside looking in when it comes to playoffs, but that doesn't mean I can't go out and give it everything I have one last time. So here goes nothing.
It's the NBA on 2K Sports. This is Kevin Harlan with Clark Kellogg and Greg Anthony. And joining us in a bit later from the sidelines, Doris Burke. Earlier this season, it was Toronto who came out on top in the last matchup against the Brooklyn Nets. They've got the edge, two wins in three games against this team, going for number three here.
I was really impressed with their passion to win. I mean, it's one thing.
On the floor for the Nets. A new group in now for the Raptors. Biombo, he's checked in for Patterson. Terrence Ross comes in for Damari Carroll. Powell, he's checked in for DeMar DeRozan. And it's Joseph in for Kyle Lowry. Setting the floor for the Raptors. Terrence Ross is out there with Bismack Biyombo. Then there's Jonas Valanciunas. Then it's Corey Joseph. And it's Powell in at the two. And what you have to like out of Valanciunas last season, improved efficiency. The game really, Clark, seemed to slow down for him.
Yeah, he entered the league a little green. I mean, would make a lot of mistakes, but had excellent tools. So with enthusiasm and hard work, you knew it was just a matter of time with him.
And right from the start, Kevin, they've been pounding the glass. Most of those 50-50 balls also going their way.
Well, I don't think there's any question about it. They came focused and ready to play. I mean, they're doing everything they can to put things in their favor. You earn that, and they're actually earning it well right now.
They're not shooting their first free throws of the game.
And it's been an average year, really, at the free throw line for this group, only around 75%.
Wayne Ellington's checked in for free. Nets trail by seven. So for Toronto right now, the star pair of Lowry and DeRozan are the guards. Patterson is the four with Valanciunas in the middle. And it's Carroll in at the three. And a chance here to catch up with the fourth member of our crew, Doris Burke. Hi, Doris.
Well, Kev, Freak in the last matchup against the Wizards made some terrific plays. He had 9 points, and in addition to his scoring, he also came away with a season high for rebounds. His performance will be a high note in what has been a disappointing season for his team.
All right, thank you as always, Doris. And another special game from a player that we know is incredibly capable for this team.
Yeah, and he proved his value again in that last game. I mean, he's a cog in their machine, no doubt.
Yeah, and they're going to need a few other players to lend a bigger hand today. I mean, they can't expect him to carry the entire load two games in a row.
Very dangerous to leave a guy like that open. Lucky break there for the D.
DeRozan, that falls. Nice feed that time from Kyle Lowry. Lowry's got his third assist on the night. For Brooklyn, they've gone 3-7 shooting the ball here in the second quarter. Clark, they've been looking out of sync offensively.
You know what? A basket here would do a lot for their confidence. You know, Dwayne Casey was once a player at Kentucky. Took me and hosted me on my recruiting visit at Kentucky back in 1979. Actually got his coaching start at the school as well.
And Carroll gets it to go. And for those of you just joining us, we're in the second quarter with about 3 minutes gone by. Here's Kilpatrick. He's been patient so far. Nothing yet on the scoreboard. It's stolen by Valanciunas. Lopez against Carroll. Now here is Lowry. Takes it from 10. And there's Valanciunas on the assist by Lowry. And it's an 11-point Raptor lead. As we were talking about Coach Dwayne Casey, he's found his place in Toronto. Took them, Greg, to back-to-back postseason appearances.
And, you know, it's good to see him finally establishing himself as a head coach. Really known as a defensive specialist. But once he gets in charge of a team, he'll have them focused on defense and really stresses that in every practice.
Carroll, no one around him. Stayed with it, but they couldn't get it to fall.
Just not there from a rhythm standpoint right now. It's really eluding him.
It's tipped. It's stolen by Valanciunas. Outside Lowry. He dishes a two to Rosa. And it's a defensive 3-second violation. And a chance to catch up on some numbers here. The hustle stats for the Raptors.
Boy, they've really amped up the pressure at the defensive end.
And so that brings the first half to a close.
Thanks, Kip.
far not a tightly contested game, guys, but, you know, anything can happen.
You know, Lowry is playing well.
He has 11 points and 4 assists.
He's been their leader, stirring the drink at the offensive end and then anchoring the defense.
And yeah, Clark, what an example he's been setting out there.
They've got Jared Jack. Brooke Lopez is out there with Young. And it's Bogdanovich in at the three, the small forward. So that's the
I can't believe we are.
And so the big win by Toronto in a tight game. This win, such a tremendous emotional...
Freak!
Forget about that one.
Come on, Freak!
Kyle, congratulations on the...
The 2K Sports post-game show.
Thank you, Kevin. And now let's move on to the presentation of our Jordan Player of the Game, Kyle Lowry. What are your thoughts, Ken?
It seems like Kyle Lowry...
And that'll do it for our coverage of this year's final regular season contest. It has been a wild ride. For Shaquille O'Neal and Kenny the Jet Smith, I'm Ernie Jones. Now the playoffs begin on 2K Sports. See you back for that.
I know money isn't everything to you, Freak, and I find it hard to say this, but I've grown to respect that in you. You're a man of conviction, but it's my responsibility to point out the consequences of that way of thinking. Now, for you, winning is everything, but winning isn't something you could do alone. It requires excellent or, at the very least, competent coaching, contributing teammates, and God willing, good health. And we all know that's not a guarantee. Now, the reality is you're not in control of any of those other factors, but if you, as the star player, fail to win and deliver a championship, you will be held responsible. You will be scapegoated, you will be villainized, and you will be punished accordingly. So when you say to me that as a free agent, all you care about is being in the best position to win, I understand what you mean. But again, that's not only up to you. Now, I'm gonna call my guy at Apollo Jets. I'm gonna get us a private plane for this tour. I promise you, you're gonna love the free agency experience. Now, your relationship with Vic has unfortunately cost us in some of these negotiations. We had 10 teams interested, we now only have 3. But thankfully, you wised up when it came to Vic. Have you been in contact with Vic? Yo, Freak, look at me.
He still has one of my cars, Dom.
What did I tell you about the L word?
The L word? What is...
Loyalty. I don't know what kind of hold this Vic has over you, but it makes me scared. You're a free agent for the first time in your career, and the only person you need to be loyal to is you. You need to be an FOF. You need to be a friend of Freak. Let's forget about winning without appropriate compensation and loyalty that hasn't been earned and isn't deserved. This is a tough business, Freak. We need to be tougher. Come on.
Cece?
Woo! Lord Jesus, I was about to blow a gasket. Okay, Freak. Now, there are very few options on the table, and I want you to explore them all before making your final decision. Whatever you decide, it needs to be an informed decision, not an emotional one. The larger the markets, the greater resources at your disposal, and exposure for you. But if you don't allocate these resources properly, then it's just a big spotlight on you as you lose.
Well, thank you kindly, big sis.
She's right, Freak.
Thanks,
Don. Absolutely. Team Freak. That's what we're about.
Oh, whoa, I don't know if I like this.
What?
Dom and CC high-fiving like that?
I mean, yeah, why you got so certain I'm gonna lose?
Whoa. No one thinks you're going to lose.
You guys sure sound like it.
We just want you to select a franchise that has great coaching, super talent, exposure, but most importantly, a ton of cap space. If the team doesn't win and you're to blame, at least you won't be broke. Capiche?
Capiche.
Also, you should make sure it's somewhere you want to raise a family, but no pressure.
You guys have made this decision so much easier.
What did Mom and Dad say?
You know what they said. I mean, but honestly, I'm torn. I've heard and listened to what you've all had to say. Don't take this the wrong way. There's just one person I haven't heard from, and that's Vic.
Lord help us.
Yo, Vic, where you at? I've been trying to call you, man. Hit me back.
You know him. He's probably somewhere too loud to hear his phone.
I don't know. I think Vic's actually upset with me.
Like we always do at this time. Keep the cold blowing your mind. Hey, dummy, this no accident. All of this was designed. Took my time. Keep the crack from behind. And I opened up your blinds. Rise and shine. Cold world. Same. Used to drive around with your girl. In my mama's Civic. Now I'm out here trying to get it. I ain't like you. Boy, I spit it how I live it. So when you see me in the streets, man, I ain't got a mimic. Cause I ain't got an image to up.
I'd like to thank everyone for coming here today. I especially like to thank God, my Lord and Savior, my family, my agent, Mr. Don Pagnotti, twin sister and manager, Cece, my lady. Thank you guys for all your support. I'd also like to thank all the fans, and all the people out there who consider themselves an FOF, friend of free. My free agency has been nothing short of amazing. And frankly, it has been a dream come true. But like most dreams, the reality is very different from what I imagined. Though I wouldn't change a thing about this period and the time I spent in the NBA, I can honestly say that nothing has been more gratifying and more difficult than choosing where to play next year. I sought the wise counsel of my loved ones. Nothing puts me at ease more than knowing that regardless of my decision, you guys will be there for me no matter what. Now, there are so many wonderful teams in the league, each filled with stellar talent and all vying to be number one. For me, there's nothing more important than winning and surrounding myself with those who feel just as passionate about the game as I do and have an unrelenting desire to win a championship ring. That's what matters most to me. It is for this reason, above all, I've decided to go to the Golden State Warriors.
They have on that team, they're going to the championship this year.
You think so? You know what that means.
I'm going to get cha-ching.
I love it.
I know.
That's my man. All right,
sir. Congratulations.
I've been running.
Three letters. M-A-X.
Dom, we trust, baby.
Dom, we trust.
Oh, yeah, I saw that dance he did.
I gotta call, I'll be right back. I gotta call finally.
Yo, fool, where you been? I've been trying to call you.
Mr. Freak?
Yo, who's this?
This is Officer Vasquez with the 9th Precinct.
Officer Vasquez? What did Vic do now?
Mr. Freak, there's been an accident. Look, we're gonna need you to come down to the following address as soon as possible.
What kind of accident? Put Vic on the phone.
I can't do that, sir.
No, you're not hearing me. I want to talk to Vic.
Look, sir, we need you to calm down as soon as you can.
No. Hey, listen. Put down the phone, and I don't want to hear it get picked up until Victor Van Leer is on the phone.
Give me the phone.
Put Vic on the phone.
Mr. Freak, Mr. Van Leer was killed in a car accident.
What's going on? Give me the phone.
The car he was driving was registered to you. We were able to identify him from the flyers.
Listen to me.
Possession.
Freak,
I don't want to talk to you no more.
Freak, give me the phone. Hi, excuse me. Hi. Yes.
This is Cece. This is Freak's manager. Who am I speaking with?
Hi. Yes, look, we're going to need somebody to come down and identify Mr. Van Leer. Eyewitnesses say that he was involved in a car chase. Two cars were chasing him, and as the chase escalated, he eventually lost control and crashed. Look, I'm really sorry for your loss.
Hello. Outside of the deceased, was anybody else injured?
Vic died in a car accident.
What?
Yeah, they said he was in a car chase.
Please, no.
Freak, I'm sorry. He died.
Sis, all started here.
Yep, right here in the dome.
Yeah, man, I was all about living the dream.
Yo, that was crazy.
No, I need some fight, man.
Like, really, I knew he was gonna die.
He says that glitters ain't gold.
Yeah, I'm gonna miss my brother Vic, though.
Deep down, he was a good person at heart, but he was never quite right. Something was always off with him, yeah. Even when we were little growing up.
Yeah, I know, but I loved him anyway. I knew he was trying to take advantage of our friendship, but I didn't care. We're boys, ride or die. You know that?
Ride or die.
Just hope Vic finally found peace and depth that he never found in life.
Well, may he rest in power. When you really sit down and think about it, life is like the length of blink of an eye. And that's for sure quick. We spend a third sleeping in bed, a third trying to figure this thing called life out. Yo, by the time we think you got it all figured out, you only got a third of your life left.
Yeah, life's a trip.
Say that again.
Life's a trip.
10 times 10.
Well, honey. Hey, yo, shout out to my man, Vic.
Shout out to Vic. Come on, let's bounce.
All right.
Yeah, I'm about to wake up the project like I used to.
Better
remember?
Not. You better not. You ain't kids no more.
Cece?
Cece.
Hey.
Why are you sneaking up on us?
Yeah, we thought you two left town yesterday after the funeral.
We decided to stay one more day.
Oh, I'm so glad you did. I wish we had known you were coming. We would have made you something to eat.
Yeah, okay.
What y'all doing?
Yeah, chatting.
Yeah, talking about yesterday's service.
Oh, okay.
How you holding up, son?
You know what? I'm okay, Pops. But you know what? We love you two so much. And it's only now that I'm realizing how much you two sacrificed for Cece and myself. Hey, you know, Vic didn't really get to know his father growing up. And we were lucky to grow up in a household with two loving parents. And you know what's sad to say? People thought we had a highly unusual home in a project.
Yeah, folks always talk about the negative effects of boys with no father in a home, but it affects girls too. And it's helped me in my relationships with men in my life.
What men?
Anywho, I know that all men are not dogs because I had a great father in the home. You, Daddy.
I was there, too. He didn't do it alone now.
Yes, Mama, of course. It goes without saying.
Thank you, daughter. I did what my father did, and his father, before that. A man, a real man, will always be involved in his children's lives. I love your mother. We had our ups and downs. But I love her more than life itself. You two are a direct result of that true love.
Yeah, we know that.
Switching subjects. Yeah. I know the both of you like I know the back of my hand. You said you were leaving after the service. Why are you here out of the blue?
Yeah, what's up?
Why gotta be all that?
Yeah, we can't stop by and show our love and appreciation for our loving parents. I'm highly offended.
I am appalled.
What's happening?
Yeah, come clean.
Okay. Me and Cece just want to give you a little present.
Yeah, a small token, a small repayment for everything you've done for us.
Yeah, all the sacrifices you've made.
And we want nothing in return but your love and grandchildren.
But first.
Maybe one day.
Maybe. But one day is not today.
Nope.
Okay. Well, for real, we do have an actual flight to catch tonight.
For real this time.
Yes, for real this time.
All right. Yeah. Y'all call us as soon as you get back.
All right, as soon as you land.
All right, promise.
Take care of your brother.
Of course, always.
I got this. No trust.
Hey, did you forget something?
No. Can you do me a favor and head to the sofa?
Sofa? What's at the sofa?
Just look behind the cushion.
Behind the cushion? Pete, come here.
What they... Now.
What's in the envelope?
Neji! Do you know Vic died? Vic, the dude that's on the, NBA 2K16. Vic? Yeah, he had died. Vic, on the, you don't know what I'm talking about, huh?
No, and I don't care.
Okay, I'm just telling you. Chill.
Just look inside, mama.
I'm tired as fuck. I have not gotten no sleep.
I woke up at 7. Me, 10.
Does it look like it opened the doors?
Keys to her house.
Uh-huh. Walking up all night and I had to go to school.
So, I done told you and your sister a million times. Me and your mother are very comfortable right where we are. This is home USA. Project or no project. This is our project. This is the home we made for you to raise you up, right? We're not moving like everybody else. Tell them.
Frequency, we both appreciate it very much. I mean, we're very grateful.
Okay, look, there's something else in the envelope.
He says, look inside the envelope.
What?
Well, look inside.
Montego Bay, Jamaica. Baby, pack your bags.
We are living the dream.
Thank y'all. Love you.
All right, love you guys.
Love you.
Dear freak. By the time you read this letter, I'll be long gone. I wrote this letter because it's the only way I think my voice will ever be heard. This piece of yellow paper is the only way I'll ever get any of you to stop. Listen, and really get to know me, Victor Van Leer. My childhood was turbulent. But even in the most unsettling times, there was a break in the tide. Father was the rocky water, and my mom's was the gentle surf. Pops did a lot of foolish stuff, but when he wasn't trashed and was actually taking the time to be a father, he'd say, Vic, you got one life, a fragile life. God can take this life whenever he sees fit. So live and live plentiful. Each day God gives, live it in abundance. My pops was a smart dude. Most dangerous kind. Educated and street smart. And this apple didn't fall too far from the tree. My mom's. Yo. She was an angel. No matter how heavy the hand, she would do anything for me. And by chance, when I was casted into that darkness, she was the voice I followed back to the light. I was so young. Too young. But my decaying flesh carries the scars and memories that won't fade. She's the reason I'm as loving as I was. She taught me to look at others as human beings and not objects. Now, where there's pain, a simple kiss, hug, or I love you, could disperse that rainy day. That's why I'll never understand why why she of all people was taken from me. The only one good thing I ever had in my life. And that was my mother. You ever feel lonely? Well, I didn't have any siblings. No one would claim me as their own. It is the first time in my life I question the point of living at all.
If
it wasn't for your family taking me in, I swear I was going to open my wrist or jump in front of the A train. But I found love. And I found it through my new family. Mr. Pete, man, he was the complete opposite of who my dad was. He was foreign to me. He was a good... I've never met one hottie that came close to her.